AG Doll Daughter Hope Faith, and I am here with Miss Heather Davis from Chic Sweets Fine Desserts.
Hi everyone, it's good to be here with you.
I'm so glad that I was able to contact you so you could be on our show.
Yes. Thank you for having me. I'm delighted to be here.
I am delighted to be here with you. Since it is Women's History Month, I wanted to interview the owner, Miss Heather, of Chic Sweets Fine Desserts. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so question number one. What inspired you to switch from teaching? Did I tell you she's a former teacher? What inspired you to switch from teaching to owning your own bakery?
Wow. Well, I can't say that it was one singular thing. It was a combination of things. But just to give you a little history about me, I was a former teacher, but before I became a teacher, I would bake with my mother. I was 8 years old and we would bake chocolate chip pecan cookies. I can remember it like it was yesterday. And I come from a really big family. Five total. Two brothers, three sisters. And when I had that one-on-one time with my mother, it was so impactful.
Right.
And you know, when you're a child, you like to work with your hands, right? And so I can't really pinpoint whether it was working with my hands or that one-on-one time I had just with my mom and not having to share her with my siblings. So the combination of that made a really big impact on me. And I carried that. I carried that talent. I carried the dream of owning a bakery with me my entire life. But of course, your parents want you to be safe and they want you to take a traditional route. And so I became a teacher, which I always wanted to be a teacher too. And I thoroughly enjoy teaching. I thoroughly enjoy working with young children and helping them understand concepts and seeing the light bulb go off. And, you know, their eyes would light up when they understood,
right,
you know, a concept, and teaching them how to read and things like that. But there was a deeper calling on my life, and I would bake for my coworkers. I would bake them at night, bring warm cookies to work, and just burning the candle from both ends. I enjoy teaching and I enjoy baking. And about 9 years into teaching, my parents were like, you gotta choose one or the other. I was burning the candle from both ends. And they told me that they would support my dream. They were like, okay, we'll support this dream of you becoming a teacher. I mean, a baker. And I gave up teaching, and here I am.
I love that.
Yeah.
Have you ever thought about teaching baking?
I have loved, so that's the best of both worlds.
Right?
I genuinely enjoy teaching. I mean, you can take the girl out, or the woman in this case. You can take the woman out of the classroom, but you can't take that, you know, that away
the
from
feeling.
Yes, so I still enjoy helping people to understand concepts, except in this case, instead of vowels and consonant clusters, I'm teaching people how to bake, and I have started a blog, and you can find that on my website. I've, you know, shared a few of my recipes, true recipes. I didn't omit any ingredients, exactly how I would bake them here in my kitchen at my bakery. But I'm also gonna take some of your advice and start offering cooking courses.
Ooh.
Here at the bakery. I've thought about doing some summer camps for young people.
That's fun.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah.
Did I mention that these are also brownies that she baked, and I am so excited to try one.
Oh, thank you. Oh my goodness.
I love chocolate so much. These are delicious. You guys have to stop by to get some of these. All right, so next question, or?
Before we move on, these are my gluten-free brownies, and sometimes they rival the bestseller, which are the lemon bars, depending on what time of year. But these are just, you know, a crowd favorite.
Oh, I mean, I can see why. These are delicious.
Thank you.
You're welcome. On to the next question, then. So, question two. What have been the biggest challenges you've faced as a female business owner?
Good question. Oh my gosh. Okay, so it's National Women's History Month, right?
Right.
And quite often, women businesses are not funded as well as male-led businesses. So that's really been one of my biggest challenges. So I've had to find alternative ways to raise funds for my business. And you and your family have been so generous enough to support me for each time I created a crowdfunding campaign. So just a little bit of, you know, background knowledge about crowdfunding campaign, because traditional banks are often, they're known for denying business loans to new businesses. We've had to come up with alternative ways to fund businesses. So if each person chips in $5 here, $10 there, $50 here, then you can create enough funds to open up your own space. So there are multiple ways that we can, you know, create funding for women-led businesses, and that's the way that that's worked for me. And so at each stage of my business, I've gone back to crowdfunding. I've crowdfunded more times to help grow my business. Now, it took a little bit longer had I gotten a traditional loan.
Right.
But, you know, steady, growing steady and slowly is sometimes better than taking off too quickly.
Right.
So that has worked for me.
I like that.
Yeah, I would say funding has been one of the biggest hurdles for me, biggest challenges.
Well, I'm so happy that you were able to overcome it.
Thank you.
And whenever you're doing a crowdfunding, where can the viewers find that to help you out?
Good question. Oftentimes, I will announce it on my social media pages. You can also find it on my website, too.
Okay.
It's like a little banner at the top of my website.
What's the name of your social media?
Social media, She Sweets Fine Desserts. I believe all of the handles will lead you to Facebook, Instagram. I'm now on TikTok. I'm on TikTok. I've heard really, you know, TikTok has its challenges, but it's been a way to generate some interest in my business. But on TikTok, I'm known as, you know, my name, Heather Davis.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Next question. Here is my next question. What advice would you give to young women looking to start their own business?
You've got some great questions. I would say to, when you have a dream and it's tucked away in your heart and it just, it's like nagging, it won't leave you alone, you have to give that attention. You have to nurture it. I would also recommend, if you want to turn it into a business, get some training, get some, take some classes. There are so many ways, so many support systems. You know, your family, there's also the SCORE mentors. If you go to score.org, there are mentors there. And I even took a class with the University of Houston.
Oh, wow, that's cool.
It was a 12-week course, and they pair you with a mentor that helps you with every question that you have.
And that's nice. So everybody gets like their own mentor?
Everyone. And it's a student. They pair you with a student that's earning his or her business degree.
I like that. Okay, that's really cool. Thank you for the advice.
Completely free.
So my next question is, what has been the most rewarding part of owning your own bakery?
Oh, wow. Just, you know, it's incredible to finally get here to this point. This has been years in the making. And just to see an idea, something that was planted in my heart, you know, I believe in a higher power, so I can't, you know, I have to recognize my higher power. But just to know that was tucked away in my heart and I never let that dream die, and I just nurtured it, and to watch it just continually develop, that has to be the most rewarding thing. And to get paid for something that I love to do already,
right?
It's the icing on the cake.
You have that glow in your eyes.
So my friend calls it egg beater bliss. Anytime I like say something on Instagram or I write something and she sees she can tell that I light up.
Right.
When it comes to baking. But she calls it egg beater bliss. That's what you're seeing.
I like that. Yeah. It's personalized.
It is. And it's just true of my nature. I enjoy you know what? Let me tell you, let me state it this way. So in order for a business to thrive, of course you have to make money, right?
Right.
You have to be profitable. But for the longest time, for me, what was the most rewarding thing was when someone take a bite of my brownies and their eyes light up. That was super rewarding for me. But I had to not focus so much on this, because this, of course, is working, and focus more on the business aspect.
Oh, right, right.
So you gotta manage both.
All right, next question. Okay, so what are some of the ways that you have or plan to celebrate Women's History Month in your bakery?
Oh, good question. So, in my bakery, well, can I answer it this way? I actually try to be cognizant and aware of patronizing small businesses. Women that have started their businesses, I try to make sure that I connect with them, make sure that I support them, sort of like a sisterhood.
Right.
And I was in the Conroe area a couple of weeks ago, and just to be honest, I was taking my mother to the ophthalmologist, and when I was in that area, I remembered that one of my friends opened up her own bath and body shop. And she sells candles, yes, lotions and everything. And it was International Women's Day on that day. So it all worked out just well.
Wow, that's
and
awesome.
I made sure that I went by and patronized her business. And I just support. I support women, I support small businesses, but I really try to, you know, it's like a sisterhood. You support each other.
Right.
So many women have supported me, and I just want to return the favor.
You have to have each other's backs.
So not necessarily in the bakery, but just creating that camaraderie.
Right. I like that. I like that. I love that a lot.
Thank you.
So I'm going to ask you one final question to really have a full conclusion. You are always striving to be inclusive, so can you tell us about some of the ways that you're inclusive to all genders and allergies, gluten-free, like these delicious brownies?
Oh, of course, everyone is welcome. I mean, we don't discriminate against anyone, especially if you have an allergy. We have allergen-friendly pastries that include everyone. If you maintain a vegan diet or a gluten-free diet, we have something for you here, and everyone is welcome, male, female, everyone. We welcome everyone.
I love that. Well, thank you for being on the show. I appreciated your time. I loved enjoying talking to you.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for coming.
You're welcome. The brownies were delicious. They're also gone, so. And put in the comments what you did for Women's History Month and what you're doing. Bye, guys.